how much they trust their guys in this situation if they decide to take a shot.
His ball complete to Rager. And he'll be taken down, but not before they work it across midfield. Now we'll get a quick timeout called by New Orleans, number two, as the clock will stop with 18 seconds to go in the first half. First down, Breeze. He's got his all-pro receiver, Michael Thomas. And he'll have it in the red zone before it crosses over out of bounds.
Boy, 30 more yards and another first down.
First and 10 at the 18-yard line.
Just like that, they'll operate from the red zone now on first down. There's Breeze. Maybe he hits him in stride. And he'll take it in the end zone for a Saints touchdown. An 18-yard touchdown grab. And the Saints have taken the lead. Good start to the season for him. He had the touchdown last week in the opener and a second one in week two now.
How about the pace he's already established, right? Not sure he can keep it up for an entire season, but don't burst the bubble because he thinks that he can.
Do guys go into a season with a goal for touchdown scored or yardage? What do you think?
I think every single one of the guys who's going to touch the football, they all have those types of goals. They all have those types of thoughts. Then they just have to see how the season unfolds if they can stay with it.
Unfolding so far so good for him.
They'll take over, first down and 10, at their own 25-yard line.
The offense back out there at the line, ready for their next drive. And from this spot in the field with the clock where it's at, you think we're just going to see a knee and that's it?
And I think in this situation, that's the proper play.
Oh, you saw that one coming. It's intercepted. Torn back across his body. Picked off at the 39. And he'll be out of bounds as time has run out on this first half. So we've reached halftime here in a four-point game as we send you on over to Orlando for Jonathan Coachman in our EA Sports Halftime Report. Take it away, Coach. Set now to go for the third quarter. The Saints have the lead and set to receive the kick.
And this will make it into the end zone.
And we will not see a return to start the half as this will be a touchback. Getting set for their next drive, the New Orleans offense. And for them, a touchdown their last go-around. Obviously, they'll be hoping to do that again.
And when you start plotting for this drive, when you start thinking to yourself, okay, what are we going to do? You don't go away from what you did before because that worked.
There he goes, right side. 20, 10, touchdown, New Orleans. Alvin Kamara, his second touchdown on the season. And the Saints now add 6 to their lead. I don't think you can get any more efficient or tidy, whatever word you want to use, than that. Man, one play, 75 yards, end zone.
Yeah, efficient, tidy, excellent words. How about explosive? 75 yards, one play. That means everyone handled their assignment, doesn't it? It doesn't just mean that the defense broke down. They really executed the way that was drawn up on the whiteboard. Big time play, big time result.
This taken in about 4 yards deep.
And beyond the 20, but not by much. In fact, just a yard pass there to the 21.
At their own 22-yard line.
The offense now at the line, ready for their next drive. They trail offense, first time to touch the ball in quarter three, and we'll see what they can do.
And I can't wait to see what they have planned, because some teams script to start a half. Other teams just go, okay, these are the sequence of plays we want to run. These things worked well for us. And sometimes they throw in that big chunk play right away.
Shocker.
Try and get after them early and try and create a big play to give themselves some momentum.
See what they have up their sleeve. Throwing again on second down. Brady, that's going to be caught by Samuel. And he's taken down, but able to slip across the 35. 12 yards there and a first down.
12. First down, Diablos.
Working from the gun, it's Brady. Open man is Samuel, complete. And that play is blown up, losing yardage back at the 35. That one unable to develop, never got going. A loss of a couple, and it's second down. Now a man open down the middle of the field. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. 16 yards, a first down. Again, it's Brady. He completes this into the hands of Miller. 5 yards on the catch there, brings up second down.
When you see zone defense and you know you've got a drag route on as your primary call, you've got to be really careful as a passer about how far you let your guy go, because he might wander into some tough coverage.
And here he'll be brought down a little shy of the 35 at the 36. 9 yards to pick up there, and it's a first down.
And the Mexico City first down.
Brady's throw there, incomplete.
They've given up a few first downs on this drive, but getting the incompletion there, that should give them something to build on and maybe turn the tide.
Brady will try again on second down. Open man is Howard, the tight end. And they'll get 8 out of this before being stopped at the 28. That'll leave them with a 3rd and 2 coming up. They got 8 yards there. They fake the handoff. Now Brady rolling to his right. And he's got a man. It's the tight end Howard, complete. And this is going to be another first down as the tackle's made at the Saints 16.
Looked like the defense put pretty good pressure on him, but he's able to flush out to his right to try and evade people. On the run, had to get on his horse. Still accurately throws a nice pass for a first down.
So the ball down to the 16 here for 1st and 10. They're going to run the sweep. It's Samuel. And he'll be out of bounds. Another nice gain, 16 yards there, and a 1st down again.
I think the reason that this play is so successful is not just the blocking at the point of attack, but how about the speed at which he takes the handoff? He's in motion already. So he's not coming from a flat start like a running back often is. He's at a full run by the time he gets the football.
And they've got 3 tight ends here on 1st and goal to add some extra mass. They'll try and run it in with Bell. And that'll hurt the average a bit, as this time they're able to get him behind the line. It's a loss of a yard there, and now 2nd down.
Good job there defensively to push him back on 1st down. I'm not sure if this is 4 down territory or not, because they can't.
And he is into the end zone for a touchdown. Le'Veon Bell, his 2nd touchdown of the afternoon. And his guys are able to make this a close game again. On that sideline, they're saying that was more like it. The 1st down run went backwards, that time into the end zone.
And I like their little bit of courage in play calling, too. Because after an unsuccessful run, especially one where you lose yardage, you oftentimes go right to throwing the football. They came right back with a running play.
And oh, it'll be intercepted. Get there and pick it. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back.
19.
And McGinnis with the kickoff honors following the touchdown. And this carries into the end zone. And this will not be returned. It'll come out to the 25.
At their own 25-yard line.
The The Saints offense on the field, ready to get their drive started. And they hit the home run last drive. One play on the ground all the way to the house. Now the defense, maybe they're expecting a run here.
Mark, I love your description, because when we talk about hitting the home run, we're usually thinking about a passing play, right? Something in the air, deep ball. Them just taking it. Big time joint. Now if you're coming back out, now they've established this run game, the play action pass could very well be open.
So you got the lead here in the second half. Obviously, you love big runs like that at any time. Here, you really like them.
And how about the confidence that's being exhibited by that offense now? They don't care what you're lining up doing on the defensive side. They want the big fella to carry the football and carry it often.
Looking for the end zone. And incomplete on the deep ball. The target that time, Michael Thomas. And it's second down.
Looks like they went for the combo play there. A nice ample gain on the ground on the previous play. Going for the big shot on that one, unsuccessfully.
Off the play fake to Kamara. It's Breeze going for it all. That's going to be knocked away and incomplete. Jalen Reagor was the intended receiver, and it's third down. So back-to-back incompletions. Third down here in 10, but you're still in field goal range.
And that's the thing to keep in mind. They're in field goal range, so now you don't take any unnecessary risks, but you try and find a way to get back to what you were doing earlier in the drive in order to finish this one off.
And he gets it inside the 10 to the 9. They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a first and goal.
At the 9-yard line.
They'll run out of the gun with Kamara. And the Saints are going to have a first and goal forthcoming as he takes this down to about the 5-yard line.
Well, Brandon, we always know that once you score one touchdown, you're without a doubt. And so far today, he's got one, but was denied as he tried to get the second one.
Kamara trying again. And he's going to press this one forward as they stop it right around the one. Give him right around 4 on the carry. We'll see if they want to keep pounding here on third and goal.
And goal.
As he was met and dropped behind the line there. Fourth down now after a loss of 2.
A loss of 2 yards.
Now the defense going to use the first of their timeouts. And as the two teams talk it over on their respective sidelines, we take a break. And no hesitation about this decision here. Confidently, they're going to go for this. Fourth and goal from the 3. They'll go for it. It's Breeze. And he's got it. Touchdown, Saints. Adam Trautman. His second touchdown on the season. And the Saints able to stretch that lead out further. That seemed pretty ideal there for the offense, Charles. You take a little bit of time off the clock here in the third quarter, decent length drive, and you pad your lead as well at the end of it.
And what it does is let you feel like you're in control of this game, even more so than a 2-touchdown lead, right? Because you have taken that time off, as you noted, which means they couldn't get you off the field. You ran your playbook the way you wanted to, and you gave your defense some rest. What a big-time drive in that situation.
Back now here live in New Orleans, as it looks like we are just about set and ready to begin with the 4th. Back out there at the line, ready for their next drive. And the script really is flipped for them. The momentum on the other sideline, and now they have to try and battle back from a 2-score deficit. Looking for more there on first down, but this throw downfield, incomplete.
This defense is continuing to contest every deep ball that is thrown downfield. And look, it doesn't matter whether you're playing man or zone. Eventually, that becomes man on man. And you've got to trust yourself and go up at that moment of truth and make a play on the football.
The throw over the middle, taken in. And he'll get this one way up just shy of the 45-yard line. That one, a gain of 20 and a first down. Shotgun now for Brady. And Samuel caught left side. There he goes, left side. Touchdown. Curtis Samuel, his second touchdown on the season. And his guys have made this a one-score game now. So that's a really big play here in the fourth quarter. And don't look now, they're right back in this game.
Did it feel to you as it did to me that maybe they were a little bit soft in what they were lining up with on defense? Almost like they were protecting the lead rather than trying to make a play.
And now that lead is down to just one score. But McGinnis with the kickoff honors following the touchdown. Fielded a couple yards into the end zone. And he'll just take a seat, and the drive will begin at the 25-yard line.
25-yard line.
Getting set for their next drive, the New Orleans offense. They've been rolling the last couple of drives, each ending in touchdowns. So this game is flipped. They were down, now they're up with the football. We'll see how they handle it.
Can we get a spy on the headset now between the head coach and offensive coordinator? Because they've been in attack mode, had to get back into the game. Now they have the lead. Do you stay on the attack, or do you dial it back a little bit to try and protect this lead?
Well, my cop-out answer would be somewhere in the middle. I think it's going to be a fine line, is it not?
I think you're exactly right. Right, but I do think if they can stay aggressive and keep them on their heels, they'll be best served that way.
Patty's able to take this one up to the 35-yard line. 7 yards there and a first down. This afternoon, it's Kamara again, and he'll get this up to about the 40. 5 yards on the carry, good pickup on first down.
Oh, that's one to warm the hearts of all those old school football players, isn't it? Tough, hard, gritty run, got behind his pads, bowled over a few people. Look at that one, right up the gut.
So up through three quarters, no reason to lighten up now. After the pickup of five, here's second and five. Again, it's Kamara, and maybe a measure of revenge there. He's had his way in this one, but this time they get him behind the line. A loss on that play, and now third down gets tougher. Third and six. Charles, what could the offense have done to adjust and account for that?
But what you're hoping is that you figure out and you see and get a clue that maybe there's going to be some pressure coming at you, and you change the blocking schemes. Maybe you go to max protection. The biggest one is maybe you bring your running back in to try and keep you clean. But in that case, that didn't happen. Zero accountability, and a sack resulted.
The offense now at the line, ready for their next drive. Their defense accomplished step one of the mission. They forced the punt. Now they'll look to erase that deficit and take a fourth quarter lead. A gain of six there on first. 6 yards was the pickup on the last completion, so here's second and four. Operating from the gun, Brady. He's going to find his running back. It's complete. And they'll bring him down at the 27-yard line. A gain of five, good enough for the first down.
Well, that was a pretty favorable situation there. What would you call that, second and manageable? Smart play, too. Didn't force it downfield when he didn't have it. Just checked it down, let him get the first down, and that's exactly what he did.
Now, that'll hit. He lost the football, and this is picked up by the Saints. And they are going to set up shop at the 32-yard line. Obviously, you got to hold on to the football, but I've got to give credit to the defense there. Good job of knocking it free.
Yeah, because a lot of the time we just blame the offensive players for not taking care of it. How about the effort of the defensive players knowing that guys are going to, and if they're good, anticipate the contact coming and try and cover up the football, and they still find ways to knock it free.
Check, check, check.
Now a first down carry. It's Camaro. 5 yards is the tally on first down. That brings up second and five. Got to figure now, after getting that turnover, they're just going to be happy to keep the ball on the ground, right?
This is where covering the football, taking care of the ball, all the ball security terms that have ever been used, they come into play for the guys on offense right now. Just take care of it, and they've got a good chance of ending up winning this game.
They run it again with Camara. And only a yard this time as he's taken down right around the 26. And this defense here going to burn their second timeout. But you can also factor in another timeout that they'll get when the clock stops at the two-minute warning. This a big play for both sides. What will we see here? Third and four. Working from the gun, it's Breeze. He'll get this to his tight end, Troutman. And he is going to have a Saints first down by about a yard. It's a gain of five on third and four. Give him 5 yards there, and it's enough for the first. Not totally home free yet, but it's looking good as they come up first and 10. Fourth quarter, down to the final 2 minutes, and we've got a one-score game. Well, this has been all that we'd hoped for. Two of the game's all-time great QBs slugging it out in a one-score game here in the second half. First and 10. Camara there with a first down carry, but not much running room, and he takes it forward for only a couple. It's second down. Able to stay in bounds, and the clock keeps rolling. This defense right now backed up in the red zone. Another touchdown, it's over. They've got to stand tall quickly.
Been in this spot before. Now there's a little bit of desperation creeping in, and all you're doing when you're talking to your defensive teammates is first guy there, hold him up. Second, third guy in, rake at the football. Get it out. We've got to create a turnover because one more score, and this game's over.
Now the defense will burn their third and final timeout as they'll get it with just under 90 seconds remaining. And on third down, a nickel formation here defensively. To throw is Breeze. They'll set up the screen now to Camara. And a pretty nice tackle there, ranging up from his free safety spot as he'll stop him about a yard short. A short gain there of just four, and that'll bring up a fourth down.
And less than a yard.
So on fourth down, out trots the kicker in a big spot here.
A 28-yard attempt.
And Lutz puts this one through. And the drive will wind up yielding three. But from a defensive perspective, though, I think maybe they're saying, hey, we did what we needed to do, kept this a one-score game.
Yeah, without a doubt, because they were able to bleed some time off the clock, right? Put themselves in a good position, but it's not out of reach yet, okay? Being able to hold them to a field goal means that they do have a chance to come back and win this game.
The offense back out there at the line, ready for their next drive. One possession game, time very much a factor. How does the offense handle it? Oh, a crusher there as it's intercepted. Picked off at the 38, and his guys are going to get the football at the 37-yard line.
First and 10.
Well, they needed the touchdown and the two-point conversion, but they're not going to get a shot at either. This is a great play here defensively, Brandon, and in a time that they sorely needed one. And that could be enough to help get them out of here with a victory.
3 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be second down. Charles, why didn't they just take the knee there?
You're asking the question that I'm asking as well, because we've seen a lot of football where coaches decide maybe they get a little greedy. I don't know if they're doing it for stats or for what reason. We've seen it happen in college. And how about in the NFL? The miracle of the Meadowlands. All they had to do was take a knee and the game was over. The Giants ran it one more time. Ball popped free. Philadelphia picks it up and wins the game.
What year was that?
1978. I think it was in November.
Line of scrimmage. No gain on the play. It's third down and 6. Today's final.
Well, I know the points in this one you wanted to close your eyes because of all the points that were being put on the scoreboard. You're a defensive guy, but it was a fun little track meet, wasn't it?
It was, and you know the people really enjoyed this game? They're the ones that like going to batting practice at the Major League Baseball parks, right? Seeing the 14-11 game, that sort of deal. That's right up their alley with what we saw in this one.
So for the Saints, they use the favorable early schedule to their advantage as they move to 2-0. And they'll get to stay put for a few days as they'll host the Atlanta Falcons next week. Meanwhile, for our visitors, they'll fall to 1-1. And they'll be on the road next week for a matchup with the Baltimore Ravens. And for Charles Davis and our entire crew, I'm Brandon Gauden. You've been watching the NFL on EA Sports.